The Heifetz International Music Institute and its Festival of Concerts, more than 50 live.
Well, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to our Sunday matinee. This is our final concert for week four of the Heifetz International Music Institute. Welcome to everyone here in Francis Auditorium on the campus of Mary Baldwin University here in Stanton, Virginia, and of course to all of you who are watching us online via our YouTube channel or Facebook Live. And I hope you're enjoying the crisp new camera that we have too. It definitely looks a little bit better if you're watching our streams. And by the way, you can always review these streams if you're in the audience and go back and watch it again, which is a lot of fun too. Well, a day in the life of Heifetz. I'm talking to you today, still cavilling a little bit over all the activities yesterday, where we had a master class, we had Heifetz performers at the Stanton Farmers Market, we had some fantastic junior division performances at our South Market stage, and capped it all off with Dry Hootenanny, also at the South Market stage. And thinking about what it takes to be a performer and what the range of opportunities that we have for our Heifetz students, because 24 hours ago, we were having, or slightly more than that, two of the students who wound up closing the Hootenanny last night, one of them playing this wild solo kind of Cajun fiddle piece, and the other one doing some scat singing of Gershwin, began the day playing Beethoven and Mozart. And you are going to be hearing some Beethoven and Mozart in this first half. But in a way, it's imagine the depth and the ability of these artists where they can come on stage and play this music from Beethoven and Brahms and Mozart so wonderfully and beautifully, and also know that those minds and those capabilities and that artistry is also at the same time investigating and exploring all these other genres and all these other types of music making that we try to kind of give them pathways to here at the Institute. So a great afternoon, of some of the great classics of the literature and also hinting at the possibilities of what is still to come. Enjoy the performance and I'll see you at intermission. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Ariel Fentress. I'm 20 years old, and I'm from Seattle, Washington, in Orlando, Florida. Today, Mickey and I will be playing Sonata No. 2 in E-flat major by Brahms. This piece was originally written for clarinet and piano, but Brahms actually made the transcription for viola and piano himself, and of course later commented on how much he disliked the viola version. I believe we are all familiar with the tale of the love triangle between Brahms, Clara Schumann, and Robert Schumann. But today, I would like to highlight the bonds between all of them. They always shared their music together and came to each other for advice, musical and otherwise, and performed and composed music in the presence of each other for almost every piece they composed. Even for this sonata, which Brahms wrote in some of the last years of his life, he actually played this for Clara and asked her for advice months before the premiere. I believe this sonata is so beautiful and emotional, and just as Brahms shared countless pieces with his own family, I would like to share this piece with you. Thank you.
Thank you. afternoon.
My name is Yuna Kim. I am 22 years old and I'm from the Bay Area, California. 2 weeks ago, I performed with Greg the first movement of Violin Sonata No. 10, Opus 96 by Beethoven. Today, we will perform the second movement. Last time in my speech, I mentioned that the first movement represents love and gratitude for me. And the second movement, though it definitely still has those sentiments, it also is a piece to me that reminds us to cherish our friends. My teacher, Mr. Kitchen, refers to this theme that Beethoven uses in his music. Thank you, Greg. As the Goodbye Archduke Rudolph theme. In 1809, Napoleon's invasion forced Beethoven's patron, Archduke Rudolph, to flee Vienna. And I believe that this theme is a way for Beethoven to say goodbye to his beloved friend. It's found in this piece, in this movement, the third movement of Opus 97 Archduke Trio, and the Les Adieux, or Farewell Sonata for piano. I myself had to say goodbye to some friends this year. I think of my best friends who are moving to a different school, and I won't be able to see them in a very long time, as well as another friend of mine who had the kindest soul and is tragically not here with us anymore. All these goodbyes just happened to occur this past May, and it was a time of sorrow and anxiety, but I do not want to make today's performance a sad one. Even if the people I love are not with me anymore, I think it's so important for me to remember them through our memories and through music. When we perform today, I invite you to also think of someone you love and cherish. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Stephen Liu, and I am a 17-year-old violinist from Plano, Texas. Today, my pianist, Baylin, and I will be performing for you all the first movement from the A major violin concerto by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. So this piece is actually one of the only Mozart pieces that I've learned on the violin, so I could not be more happy to finally be able to share this beautiful music with you all today. So the piece begins with a very enthusiastic introduction from the orchestra part, and this is quickly transferred to my violin solo line, where I have a quite hazy yet very ethereal opening. This is quickly revived by the allegro aperto marking, with aperto meaning open. And this tempo marking sends the rest of the movement into a very lighthearted, but also very well poised tumble filled with lots and lots of humor. And so with that being said, I like to think of this piece as kind of like if the slow section was me waking up from my beauty sleep, the fast allegro aperto section is all 15 of the alarms I set the night before going off in the morning. And so with that being said, please join me in experiencing this sophisticated yet very childish nostalgia, and also in reliving the 7 a.m. alarms that wake me up in the morning. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
another shock in my eye. I just remembered it is the Sunday matinee, and that is when we choose the lucky raffle winners. So I would not be doing my job if I don't have the raffle box with me. And lo and behold, there it is.
Are you kidding me?
Okay, people, you really have to do better on the raffle front. I think somebody is going to have like a 1 in 10 chance of winning. I don't know. Okay, now the other thing we do when we choose, so just to reset here, the raffle is one ticket for $5, three tickets for $10. You know, you get the impression that all I do is just go here and raise money. Oh, right, that's my job. Okay. Anyway, enter the raffle to win a $50 gift certificate to Zinnodoa, and the final week will take all of the tickets, not just the ones of this week, and you're eligible to get a season pass to our Here and Now series. So, and we'll be talking more about that as we get into week six, but it's week five right now, so we're not going to do that. It's almost week five. But it does mean this week's lucky winner is going to be selected by a lucky selector, and I'm going to ask Ms. Amy Sato on our board to help me choose the winner here. Why don't we talk about the board meeting about pecuniary interest board, you know, right? Yeah, you know, there'd be some official reason why we couldn't do that.
I'm just going to mix it up. I have not talked to anybody who bought the
bubble. Yeah, apparently they're a rare breed. Helene Baker. Congratulations, Helene. See me after class. Okay. This is the final concert of week four, and then we move into week five with Stars of Tomorrow, tomorrow evening, right here at 7:30. Wednesday will be our next Stars of Tomorrow concert, and then one of our fantastic collaborative chamber music concerts on Thursday. And on this time, Schubert will be on the menu, so you definitely want to be here. So enjoy the rest of the program. Thank you very much.
I'm a 16-year-old violinist from Singapore. Today, I'll be performing for you Caprice No. 10, Opus 1 by Niccolo Paganini. Paganini dedicated this piece to his friend, Theodor Hallmann, who was a Belgian violinist and teacher. For this specific caprice, I imagine a person who is possessed, and he vents out his frustration and confusion. Almost like a painting of vivid splashes of red and orange, however, there is a gold lining as he discovers the small joys in life. So I hope that today as I perform, you'll be able to visualize this painting. Thank you. Thank you.
Good afternoon.
My name is Adrian Jackson. I'm 23 years old from Austin, Texas. And today, my wonderful collaborator, Tae Kim, and I will be performing the first movement of Sonata in A Minor by Franz Schubert, also known as the Arpeggione Sonata. In the viola repertoire, the sonata works by far define the instrument's voice and push the needle for what is expected of a viola performer. While this sonata isn't an original composition for viola, it has cemented itself as a staple in the chamber music repertoire. Studying this piece over the course of my musical development has admittedly been a frustrating task. I first began preparing this work in preparation for undergraduate music school auditions, so I've come to associate this sonata with that intense period of stress and exhaustion. 5 years later, and I'm still just as stressed and exhausted, but I have a newfound appreciation for this work, and I have acquired a new set of tools that I think will help make this experience different from what it was before. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
everyone. My name is Anna, and I'm 23 years old, and I'm from New Zealand. And today, my amazing pianist, Mr. Rohan da Silva, and I will be playing Sonata No. 7 by Beethoven. And Beethoven's violin sonatas are commonly known as sonata for piano and violin, with a heavier emphasis on the piano part. And while preparing for this performance with Mr. da Silva, I really gained a new perspective on collaborative playing. And there were two very important things that I learned. And they were just to be able to hear whatever my wonderful partner is doing and having complete trust in my musical partner. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.